Traffic Focus channel, and today in this video we're going to learn how you can create sign in and sign up screens in Photoshop. So to begin with, I'm just going to create a new file, new canvas, so that we can start with the work. So I'm going to choose mobile app design document type, and maybe we can just keep this iPhone 6s plus. Okay, and just duplicate it to a new layer. Okay, so now we have the canvas, and also please subscribe to the channel for more such cool videos. Okay guys, and just to keep my reference on the side of my original canvas, what I'm going to do is I'm going to just choose this windows and then go to this arrange option and choose two up vertical. So what this does is it just creates two different canvases, where one can be our reference and one can be our original design. Okay, so let's start with creating a background layer. So I'll just check the size from here. It's 1242 by 2208, so I'll just select my shape tool and click here, and I'm going to use 1242 2200 maybe. So I just turn my x and y to 0 and turn off the stroke, fill the shape layer with white color, and then maybe I guess 2210. Yeah. So here we have the background. Now we can start by creating these shape layers like this. So let's start with the yellow one. I'll just deselect it, because when a shape layer is selected and you create another shape using a pen tool or any other shape tool, then it merges it with the original shape layer. So I'll just deselect the original shape layer, that is the background layer, and I'll just draw some random shapes like this with my pen tool. Okay, so my first shape is ready. I'll just turn off the stroke. I'll use the fill color and I'll pick it from the second reference document. Okay, so we have got this one layer. Let's move it a little bit upwards like this. Then I'll just deselect the shape layers again, and I'll create another layer. I'll just go from here like this, get a curve over here. The benefit of playing with shape tools is that if you're not satisfied with the shape that you have created, you can always come back and just like change the shape accordingly. Sometimes what Photoshop does is it just creates this kind of mess. The selected shape layer gets deselected, and then it's really difficult to continue with the construction of the shape. For that, what you need to do, so my keyboard is not working properly. Okay, we have completed with our second shape, so I'll just do the same thing. I'll just turn off its stroke, I'll just select my fill color, and I'll select it from the second layer. Okay, so we need to move this shape layer under the first yellow one and keep it accordingly over there. And you can always alter the design in this shape layer that you have created later, so that can be done at any point of time using the pen tool. This is the major benefit of using shape layers. Okay, then there is this third shape, so let's create that one also. So I'll just choose my pen tool, I'll just go like this, look more like this. So our third shape is ready. I'll just turn off its scope and go to the fill color, and I will click on this here so that we have the color over there, and I'll just move it downwards. So we've got all these three shape layers. Now let's move with the text layer. So you can see it is saying welcome back. So this welcome back signifies that it is a sign in screen, okay, not the sign up screen. So if it was the sign up screen, you can see that there should be create account option. So let's increase the size of this welcome text. Then we turn off the bold and just take white color over here. Turn in the bold now. Right, and let's just create this layer mask on all of these layers. I'm just pressing Alt and I'm just clicking in the middle of these layers so that everything is under this layer. Okay, so this is how all these this is basically clipped. All these layers are clipped inside this particular background. Okay, so now let's just start creating this email layer. Let's turn off my text there, and let's turn off my bold, and I'm going to choose a grayer shape for my text, and I'm going to use the size 54. Okay, so we have got this email there, and we'll align and select both these text layers and align them to the left. Okay, like this, and maybe increase the size of it to 58. Turn its color a little bit more lighter. This lighter shade signifies that this is a text field and the user has to input something in it. If the text is a little bit darker, then the user doesn't get it that it's a text field and it has to be filled by the user himself. Okay, so I just created a shape layer to create this line under the email text, and I have chosen this little bit of lighter shade of gray for this. Like this, and I'm going to group these two layers and rename them to email, and I'm going to duplicate these layers and I'm going to create password there as well. Okay. Created this email layer and this password layer. Then after this, I'll just duplicate one of my texts. I just did it by dragging the text layer and pressing the Alt key simultaneously. So now we have a duplicated text layer, and I will use it for writing the sign in. Okay, I'll increase its size to maybe 74, and I'll pump its color to a little bit more black side. This I can probably decrease the size of these two, 54 only, or maybe 48. Yeah, and here we have the sign in there, and I can just enable this a little bit of lighter bold to the text, and then we need to create this button just like this one over here. So here we have this circle, and I'm just turning off its stroke, and I'm using fill color to be gray. Yeah, just decrease it to a little bit of 200 pixels. And since you can see these two layers are aligned, so I'll just select both these two layers and I'm just going to align them. And then you can probably select this arrow from the shapes menu and add it over here. I'll just turn off its stroke and I'll use my fill color and move it upwards in the layer section so that to make it visible. Okay. Like this. And then there are these two clickable text buttons that say sign up or that say forgot password. So let's create those also. For that also, I'm going to just duplicate this text layer. I'm going to choose the font text to be 48 maybe. Sign up. and from the text menu I'll just choose the drop down and the underline option. So that we have the underline, but sometimes what happens is Photoshop considers this underline to be very light. So what you can do is you can just turn off this underline and create a line under the text so that the developer knows that this text has to be underlined and the bold should be of a certain strength. Okay, so now we have the sign up with an underline under it, and let's move it a little bit downwards. Yes, and let's just duplicate this and say forgot passwords. Let's move it and align it with the sphere like this, and same thing I'm going to do with the underline, and I have to make this underline cover the whole text, so I'm just resizing it. Alright, so we have created these two buttons as well, so we'll just club all these items that are in the bottom area and maybe take these two a little bit upwards like this, similar with this also. So we have created this one screen, and as you can see we just are missing this back button over here, so we just use pen tool to create this back button on our own. Okay, so it has to be balanced like this. And I'll just keep my stroke with white color, and I'll just use my regular lines. Okay, and I'll just use this cap to be curved and corners to be curved as well. And I'm increasing the stroke so that the button is visible. Okay, so I'll just decrease the size of it a little bit, and maybe increase the stroke to 8 pixels, and that's it. So here we have the first screen ready. Okay, to showcase it like this, what you can do is you can just take all these elements, group them, alright, and maybe create a thing like this, and I can just curve the edges of the background layer like this. But in this design, the vertical part is a little bit longer, so we can even increase the size of this background layer like this. And you can take the group upwards like this, and then we can move the elements as we want inside it. And you can just select all these elements that you want to be moving like this. Increase the size of the sphere. Alright. And maybe increase the size of these texts as well. 54. Take them a little bit apart from each other. Give them a spacing from the design. Like this. Got the design ready, and let me just get the background color into this space. Maybe something like this to showcase you how the design looks. Okay. As you can see, we have completed designing one of the screens. So let's work on the secondary screen, that is the create account one. So this comes if some user clicks on the sign up screen. Okay, so let's just increase our canvas size like this. Okay, I'm just renaming my group like this, and I'm just going to duplicate it like this, I just use my background layer and transform it like this, and we have both the layers on the canvas now. And let's just start working with this one. Okay, so we need to change this text to create account. You can use any kind of font that suits best to your design or best to the company's branding image. Okay, and we need to create these two layers over here, so I'll just turn, let's probably delete these layers and deselect everything, and I'm going to create my first layer like this. Okay, so I have created my first layer. I just turn off its scope, and I'm going to choose this darker shade of gray over here, and I'm going to make this clipping mask by clicking Alt and pressing in the middle of these two layers so that it uses only the space that is provided in the background layer. Okay, and I'll create one more layer. So for that I'm going to be creating a shape layer over here. And I'll just turn off its scope, and I'm going to use the fill color to be this blue. Okay, maybe. Yeah. And I'll just place this layer between these two layers so that we have this fix inside. Okay. And now, as you can see, this layer is a little bit downwards. Just have to create these text layers now. Okay, so they have used white color for everything. Okay, so we'll also probably be using white color. So select these two. I have the white color over here. Select it white, then I just turn my text to white like this, and we need to create one more text field of these layers, so that needs to be name field. And instead of sign in over here, we need to have sign up. Okay, and instead of this button, we need to have underline that we have created for sign up. This is it, and we just change the color of everything to white as per the need of this design. Okay, so we'll select both these two text layers and we'll just turn its color to white. And as you can see, we have created both these two screen designs in under 18 minutes. Okay, so that was two when you are having a tutorial, but if you are fast enough, you can probably finish this in under 10 minutes as well, 10 or 15 minutes maybe. Okay, so hope you have learned something. Do subscribe to Graphic Workers channel. You can just go to YouTube and you can search for Graphic Workers. And this is the channel that you need to subscribe. Go here and just hit the subscribe button. Okay, and there are a number of videos that you can learn something good from. Okay, do leave your feedback in the comment section below. Thank you. Thanks for watching.